Well, all right. And that shook the whole table. Way to go. And now, of course, all my dogs have to come over and see what I'm talking about. So you'll hear the little nails. Anyway, so I want to do a quick video here. Basically, just a little bit of a rant about some retro games here. And generally speaking, I just got this mini-gen. I did have some problems with my first one, but they could have been a little self-inflicted on myself, which is kind of the reason why I'm making this video. What's up, Rex? Some of my games I had not cleaned since I pulled them out, and I was trying them. And it was a similar pattern where they kept resetting after 5 minutes. So I actually might retest some of my games that I did run on the unit that I thought was defective. I think it is still, actually, but we might retest that guy. But anyway, cleaning your games. So after I got my second unit, I was having sort of the same problems, and then, oh, stupid me, just kind of clicked in my head, hey, you haven't cleaned these in 10 years, and even though they've been in storage and some in cases, some of them weren't in cases, and the ones that are not in cases especially have a ton of grime, and I don't know what you'd call it. Thank you, Joe. It's just like this black gunk or muck that gets on the copper, sort of. So anyway, just we'll open this guy up. So Michael Jackson's Moonwalker. Weird freaking game. Weird game. This game in particular, though, was kind of cool for me, just because, well, A, I did play it as a kid, but before I left Ohio, I bought some retro games at the place I used to go to as a child, which was Flashback Video Games in Lorain, Ohio. And one of the guys that used to work there bought the place from the other guy when he knew, you know, that's a wrap, time to go. And this was probably in 2005-ish. He bought the place anyway years before, I think, from him then. And long story short, last game I bought from that video game store. So kind of cool. Little fun fact that nobody cares about. So I use rubbing alcohol. I've actually seen people use WD-40, which never tried. But you can probably use that. So I usually just put it into the cap, get the Q-tips like over here, and we will just go ahead and scrub away at this. Like, this guy looks pretty dirty, actually. This was one of the ones I didn't have a case for, and I ordered a replacement case. That's not the original case. Yeah, I don't know if you can see that. That's a... it's just from one brush on one side. So, I'm probably shaking the table. So it's going to be great camera work. I'm a professional YouTuber here, people. But I won't go, obviously, and clean all of these on camera. But several of these games I have cleaned. And then all of a sudden, voila, I got better performance out of my... Gen Mini. Now, the first one I was sent, though, I do think there was a problem with, because it basically made me reset my computer monitor. I think there was something coming out of that connection. Like, my computer monitor just shut down, and it kind of freaked me out. I had to unplug it and plug it back in to get it to go again. So this was the first pass on the front, and then this was the second pass. So you can see it's not nearly as black, and that's kind of what you want. You don't want any of the grime on there, because if it can't get to the copper pins when you look inside, if the cart contact and the copper pins is weak, you're going to have problems with your game either freezing up, or it's not going to run. And that's when you'll get like pink and blue screens and everything else. So when you're doing this, I would go over twice, well, really four times. Oh, that's a first. Yeah, see, this had actual yellow gunk on it. think that came from the other side of it. These were in a box, though, for like 10 years in storage, and I moved probably 5 or 6 times. More than that, actually. In that time period. And these were just kept getting thrown in closet by closet to closet in a box. And now that I've been living in this house for 2 years now, I think I'm going to keep it for a while. I like it. Just a little ranch house, but it's kind of all I need. It's a big open space in the main room, which I like. Huge backyard for my dogs, and very manageable mortgage. Thank you, Chloe. All right, so that is, it's more like kind of yellowish grime, which is interesting. I've never really seen that. So usually what I do, I go with 2 passes, one on each side of a Q-tip, on each side of the cart. And then I'll take 1 Q-tip with no alcohol, rubbing alcohol on it, which is dry, and kind of dry off the alcohol, or you know, scrub it off, and see what we get. So this got a little more black and grime on it from the dry. Which is weird. This card in particular, it's like the back portion of it is pretty tight. Which is probably why I'm getting the yellow stuff from the actual cart side, not the copper pin connection. Hey, sweetie. What's up, Chloe? Yeah, hey, you gonna say hi to the camera? It's my tiniest corgi, wants to know what's going on. And she's smelling the alcohol. Considering she just threw up, it's probably not good for her to try and drink alcohol. Yeah, see, that one's still pretty black. I might even go over this again. So typically, that was the front side. Typically, I'll keep going. Shaking the table again. Like normally, I just dry it off, right? But if you do see it, well, there's a little bit of black there. But we'll just go over this one last time, probably. I usually keep going until I don't get a heavy saturation of black from the Q-tip. So once you don't see any more black, you're probably good to go. Obviously, this takes a little bit of time. So this one should be good. Really sort of a creepy game after the fact, and since, you know, with everything that happened with Michael Jackson, you got like kids hiding in closets and trunks of cars, and he's kicking them open and they're screaming Michael and flying away on his magic pixie dust. Yes, weird metaphors there. So, but yeah, cool game though. It's, you know, ridiculous and kind of just so odd it's entertaining, you know. And obviously the soundtrack is 16-bit versions of all of his songs. And then, like, you build up this meter, and then once you build up the meter, you can, like, do the special move, and he does one of his dance routines with the enemies. Like, he puts them in a trance and then kills them. So, yeah. And my dog's going to start barking because neighbors came home. Some of the other games I'm going to clean out is Quackshot. Really great game. Recommend it highly. Strider. This was a cool game for its time. I never beat it. I just probably played it here and there. It's kind of like a Contra meets Ninja Gaiden type game. Shining Darkness. This is just kind of one of those games I own because I did play it as a kid. Unless I get really bored or like determined, I'm never going to beat this game because this game, it's a huge pain in the ass. I don't like first-person dungeon crawlers. But it's a really cool game for the time. It's kind of like a nice piece of JRPG history here. Plus, it was the first in the Shining series, which Shining Force 2 might be my favorite Genesis game of all time. I mean, really, Shining Force 1 and Shining Force 2, both great, but this one definitely took everything to the next level. Shining Force 1 is kind of more of a classic for me in the cast, but This game just has a lot more of everything, and it does it really well. And this isn't the original case either. So this is a $5 reproduction, which it looks damn good. So I'll probably go ahead and link that site in the description again, because I do appreciate what they've done. Don't get a kickback or anything, so it's just is what it is. You can order anything. Plus, they all use black cases for their SNES games and Nintendo games. They don't have every single case to select from, and then in some of them, they'll actually say on there in the fine print, "This is not a, this is not an original artwork or case." I don't know if there's a licensing issue or if they just couldn't find a good, which seems kind of odd, or if they couldn't find a good picture to print anyway for a high quality one to put in there. But there's a bunch of games I couldn't get on there, so I'm gonna have to go to my local guy, which just takes a while, because if I order it through the site, it ships and it's here in like 2-3, you know, it was like 3 or 4 days. The local guy takes a while, but he's really cool. I do like him. He just, you know, can take like 2 weeks, so it's kind of annoying. But anyway, so yeah, I was just gonna rant here a bit, probably too much, but the mini-gen, I'll actually get some gameplay videos and test some stuff out. There's a couple games I'm surprised nobody's tested on this thing. Earthworm Jim 2 or Earthworm Jim would probably be two good tests. I do have those, or I have one. Two is like on the way. Pirates, another one. Actually, if you've never played this game. So I thought this was like a Genesis sort of classic exclusive. It's not. It's been on everything, and it's been ported to everything since, as you've probably seen it. But this game is freaking classic. It was, for the time, it was like nothing like this. You pretty much just made your character. You had like a list of life accomplishments that you're supposed to try and do. Like find your long-lost 20 relatives, like father, brother, mother. Actually, I think it's sister, father, mother. And then like get married to another one. Get like a general, yada, yada, stature. Basically, you just got to keep trying to get all these accomplishments done before you die. And I want to say, yeah, that's pretty much it. I can't remember if like you can stop and then like your son takes over, or if that's it and then you just start again. I can't remember. But it's a really fun game. There's all kinds of different towns you can go to, and depending on your standings with like the Spanish, English, and Dutch, I think. You can only go to certain port towns, so you have to sort of keep rapport. I was always like, I always pretty much just fought the Spanish. It's like the Spanish are dicks. So, but you can even take over towns. So it's like there's port battles where you invade the town, take over the port, and I forget the circumstances of it, because sometimes you can just raid it and leave, and other times you actually take it over, and then you can make it like an English settlement, Dutch, all that. So there's just a lot to this game for, at the time, nobody was doing. Highly recommend trying this out if you're into retro games. I'm going to try some gameplay videos out anyway after I clean the games I want to try, like the Michael Jackson one, and then we'll see how this thing really stacks up later. It's really hard to say. I might have to get an attachment to run my original Genesis through HDMI. So that would really be what I would want to compare it to, or the Retron 5. But the Retron 5 is kind of... it's kind of not fair because it doesn't actually play the card. It just rips it and emulates. So, that's the end of this video, I guess. We'll stop ranting and perhaps pick up my corgi and see if she growls at me. She can look all cute on camera. She's going to growl at me. Oh, yeah. You say hi? Hmm? Okay. Rick. What is all this?
Good.